survey says it's 6 o'clock. Time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Daniel.
Feud, hope you had a great weekend. This is where two families battle it out for $10,000 in cash and the chance to win a fantastic Mitsubishi Outlander just by guessing the top answers to some very easy questions. First up, would you please welcome back for their third night, it's the Lansdown family.
Hi, Jan.
Hi, Grant, how are you?
Who has, I might add, Jan, won $20,000 already? So that's two from two for you
guys. That's
right, yes.
Not only that, this is her third time on a different Family Feud. Mm-hmm. It started 37 years ago. She never won any money then, but boy, she's cleaning us out now. Who's on board?
This is my niece Heidi, my sister Yvonne, and my niece Amanda.
Great to have you back.
Thank you.
And ready to take them on, it's the McDermotts. Kate, would you tell Australia who you've brought along with you?
This is my husband, Matt, my cousin-in-law, Tracy, and Matt's cousin, Aaron.
They're a big, happy family, the McDermotts! Right, ready for some fun, everybody? Team captains, round one, let's play the feud. Best of luck to the both of you. We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name a subject people talk about as if they really know what they're talking about. Jan?
Football.
What was it?
Football.
Football! Not the top answer though, but good effort.
I'm going to try politics.
OK, let's see if you're right. Were you excited about getting the call-up in the family to come and play tonight?
Well, as my wife was involved, I thought it'd be really ordinary if I didn't.
Yes, it would.
Very excited to be here.
Name a subject people talk about as if they really know what they're talking about.
Religion.
Ah, let's see if you're there. Probably not, Matt.
Oh, well.
Is it too late to reconsider?
No, it's been 20 years now.
All right.
There's no point going back.
Hi, Tracy. How
Hello.
You doing?
Good, thank you.
Name a subject people talk about as if they really know what they're talking about, Tracy.
Parenting. We'll try that.
Let's see if it's on the board.
Yes. Yeah.
Name a subject people talk about as if they really know what they're talking about.
Architecture.
Is it on the board? It's two strikes now for the McDermott, so potentially the Lansdowns could steal, so get ready. Kate?
Lots of people seem to be experts on other people's relationships.
Mm. Right. Relationships?
Yeah, you see, judge, that happens. Yeah.
Does the survey agree? Oh. Three strikes, McDermott! Oh, Kate's spewing about it too. Lansdowns, what would you say, Amanda?
Gossip or rumours?
Yvonne?
The boyfriend or the partner?
Heidi?
I'm going to go with news.
OK. Good options there, Jan.
On the same lines, I'd say news, current affairs.
News and current affairs?
Yeah.
Let's see for the steal if it's on the board. No! McDermott! They grab a sneaky little win early on and grab 58 points too. Remaining answers, 7. Lansdowns are on their third night. If they make it to 5 nights and win, they'll be taking home the amazing all-new Mitsubishi Outlander. Now, this incredibly cool SUV has room for 5 people, safety features like 7 airbags and reversing camera, plus touchscreen audio and Bluetooth connectivity. Now, here's a question for everybody playing along at home. I want the top answer to this one. Name something around the house that you empty. We'll give you the answer when we'll be back after this right here on Family Feud. Now, before the break, I asked, name something around the house that you empty. The top answer was...
Bin!
Bin, sure was. What? That's taking the bin out, if you didn't know. You didn't know I was a mime in my younger day. Right now, our families are still battling. And a terrible one at that. So they're still battling for $10,000 right now. So, Heidi, Matt, let's play the feud. surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something that you would not like to step on with bare feet. Heidi.
Dog poo.
Let's see. Right. Good answer, Matt. Mm.
Prickle.
A prickle. Pass or play, Heidi?
Pressure.
So early on yet for that.
Yeah, I know. There's a lot there.
Name something you would not like to step on with your bare feet.
Broken glass.
Ah, makes a lot of sense because it would hurt.
Yes.
Top answer. Playing well, Tracy. How about you, Aaron?
Lego.
The old late night Lego hop, my mum used to call it. Lego! Great answer though, Aaron. Kate.
I'm always going for the comedy, the rake. That's not, you know, maybe I can
rake. You like
rake.
Your Laurel and Hardy, don't you?
Stick with that one.
Give me rake. Second strike. Potentially the Lansdowns could steal, so they're getting ready. Matt.
Cigarette butt.
Yeah. What? Well, yeah, I hear you. Third strike. Sorry, Matt.
Righto, Lansdowns. Amanda.
Needle.
Yep.
Hot sand.
Yeah, cool. Heidi.
Pins.
And Jan. Again, great options.
I think I might go with needle. Or a nail. Same thing.
No, you can't. You just said needle.
Oh, we'll go needle. Needle then.
Nice try, though. Trying to go.
That was clever. I thought it too then.
Yeah. Game doesn't quite work like that, though, Jan. Give me a needle.
I go needle.
There it is! Some great points for the Lansdowns. Remaining options. Hot coals. Lansdowns playing really well, have pulled themselves back into the game on 55 points, but the McDermott's, oh, by the most slender of margins, 58 is their score right now. So Yvonne, Tracy, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something teenagers complain about. Tracy?
Everything.
Great answer.
Being bored?
Being bored.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. Pass or play, Tracy?
You want to do play?
Aaron, name something teenagers complain about.
Chores.
Yeah. Mm. Chores.
Yes.
Yeah. By the way, I think that's your first correct answer, Aaron.
Ah, well done.
You'd be pretty happy with that too, Kate.
Yes.
Something teenagers complain about.
We have two of them and they complain a lot, so everything was good, but homework.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. There you go. Matt has probably one of the most serious game faces I've seen in this series.
Sniper.
It's good.
The secret sniper.
It is. Look, it is. I'm just trying to, you know, take it all in.
Mm. Let's take this one in.
I did. I remember when I was younger, doing the dishes.
Yeah. Gee.
Bad luck.
Matt is playing appallingly tonight.
Have you?
I'm hearing you. I'm seeing it. I'm donuts.
Tracy, name something teenagers complain about.
I'm feeling the pressure because you're bagging us all, but...
I will go with I'm hungry.
I'm hungry, I like it. You say bagging, I say gentle encouragement.
That's fine, go with that.
Name something teenagers complain about, Aaron.
Are they siblings?
Each other, yeah. Second strike now. So the Lansdowns getting ready. Kate.
Picking up after themselves.
Yeah. Pretty common mistake, isn't it? All right, you need this now. You've got 2 strikes down. It's back to the captain. We're saying picking up after themselves. Third strikes. Lansdowns.
Cleaning their room.
I'll say the same, cleaning the room.
Heidi.
Unanimous.
and Jan.
It's actually unanimous.
The brave captain who overturns that.
I would never think of doing that.
We're going to go with cleaning your room. For the steel. Let's see if we can get a success for steel under the belt. Is cleaning the room on the board? Oh. No, it's not. McDermott's getting it once again. The secret sniper tactic works. Remaining answers.
Getting out of bed.
Money. The scores, the Lansdowns on their third, 9 on 55. The secret snipers themselves, the McDermott sitting on a very lovely 172 points right now. Good job. Well, love Family Feud, and you might like playing along at home with our official Family Feud game. Just head to 10 Play and all the details are there. Now, after the break, our families are playing triple points. We'll see you soon. Now the Lansdowns on 55 and the secret snipers, the McDermotts, playing beautifully right now at 172. The family who gets to 300 points in this round is going to win the game. We're playing for triple points right now. Amanda, Aaron, let's play.
Good luck.
We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name a famous monster. Aaron.
Jabba the Hutt.
Jabba the Hutt. No. Amanda.
The monster from Monsters, Inc.
The monster from Monsters, Inc. Great. All right, they get classy. You're going to play. Famous monster.
Cookie.
Let's see. Serious Matt.
Yeah.
Famous monster.
Marty.
Marty the monster.
Surely he's there. I'm running donuts.
He defined an era of children's television.
He did.
No! Oh.
Devastating.
That's my strategy. I just get them all wrong.
Have you had one correct answer yet tonight?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either. Are you okay?
It's all right, buddy.
Come on, everyone, get behind him. Give him some support. Build his confidence. We want you to do well, mate.
We're winning that. I'm a team player. We're going
all right. All right, good. Tracy, famous monster.
Oh, dear me. I'll have to say Shrek. I've got no idea. No idea.
I have a feeling it's a pretty good answer. Let's find out if you're right. Yes. Aaron.
I'll have to go with the Boogie Monster.
Does he still haunt you, Aaron?
From time to time.
I hear. That's two strikes, McDermott. So, Lansdowns, get set for a potential steal.
I'm thinking of Herman Munster.
Go with the cake. There's nothing else.
Pretty sure it's name a famous monster.
Monster, yeah, I know. And you're saying... Not a Munster.
Herman
I've got it wrong.
Munster.
Well, no. Yeah, that's where I'm at. Sorry.
Kind of a bit monster-ish. Let's see. Oh, yeah! That was pure skill.
You know. Pants flying.
I'm up again.
Breathe deep. Let's hold hands.
I've got one, I reckon.
Name, look into my eyes, a famous monster.
Frankenstein.
Yes! I love it. I love it. You ready? You do it. Let's go. Survey says.
Survey says.
I'm a famous monster, Tracy.
This is really sad. This is all I can come up with. But something from Ghostbusters?
Something?
Yes! From Ghostbusters. The Marshmallow Man. You're like walking through the streets and
there's a cast
sort
of about 3,000 people in the movie Ghostbusters.
Okay, one from Ghostbusters, like the Marshmallow Man. We'll go with
good.
That.
All right, okay, cool. A bit more specific than anybody in Ghostbusters.
I could win on that though, but.
Let's see. Good work, Tracy. Good try. Amanda.
The Hulk.
Yvonne.
The same, the Hulk.
Yep. Heidi.
Milton the Monster.
Milton the Monster, Jan. Ooh. Righto. We're in a triple points round right now. This is big for you. You currently trail. You're on your third night. You've won $20,000. That's two from two, Jan.
Yes,
nobody's done that yet in this show.
I want three.
This is 37 years you have been on this show trying.
OK, I'm going to go with Hulk.
For the steal?
Hulk. Yes, Hulk.
How do we feel about Hulk?
Hulk.
Yes. We're feeling good. We're feeling confident, Jan.
Yes.
Let's do it for the Hulk. Steal. Does Hulk give it to you? What you needed, Oscar the Grouch, Loch Ness, and Godzilla, which makes the McDermotts our brand new champions of Family Feud. Lansdown's Jan, Heidi, and Lauren, Amanda. Hey, look, we've had so much fun, haven't we, Jan?
We have.
In 37 years of trying to be on this show to finally win, which you have done and taken home 20 grand, do you feel satisfied now?
I'm happy. That's all I wanted to do. I just wanted to win. I've done that. So it's really great.
So you enjoy being on Family Feud for the third time in your life?
I'm not coming back for a fourth time.
I loved a grand, but not that much.
I'll be dead then.
They take home with them $20,000. Yeah. They are the Lansdowns. McDermott's Fast Money Time. This is the business end. Who's doing it? Wow. Who would have thunk it that this rabble bunch would become our brand new champions? It all came together in the end, didn't it?
Came to plan.
It's about persistence.
Certainly.
Surviving and just having a good old-fashioned crack. Righto, who's going first?
Me.
You're going first. You're back there. 10,000 bucks would be nice, wouldn't it?
It'd be delicious.
Tracy, let's do it. After the break, don't go anywhere.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Welcome back for the Fast Money Round, everybody. You ready to go, newly crowned champion?
I am so ready. Let's do this.
Now, if you and Aaron get 200 points or more between you, you'll win $10,000. And right now, Aaron is in our soundproof booth. And just taking it all in, really. I'm going to ask you five questions. I'm going to give you 20 seconds to answer, OK? Now, if you pass, we'll come back if there's time. The clock starts at the end of the very first question. You ready?
Ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck.
Thank you.
If you're bored, name something you might like to look at.
TV.
Tell me a breakfast food people might also eat for dinner.
Weet-Bix.
Name something women worry about.
Money.
Name something you do while you're listening to music.
Dance.
Name a kind of clock.
Pass.
Name a kind of clock.
Digital.
All right. Nice. Let's go. Right, here we go. If you're bored, name something you might like to look at. What's wrong with that face? Why are you nervous about this?
I'll feel better when it's all done.
Let's do it. You said TV. Survey says... I bet you would. That's a great start. Tell me a breakfast food that people might also eat for dinner. You said... Weet-Bix. Survey says... Aww. Name something women worry about. You said... Money. Survey says... 14. Get to 200 and you won't need to worry anymore, girlfriend. Name something you do while you're listening to music. You said... Dance. Survey says... 14. Oh, I mean, name a kind of clock. You said... Digital. Survey says... 10. OK. 63, Tracy. You're back in the family. Not impossible. Let's clear the board. You need 137 points from this next round to get you $10,000, OK?
OK.
I'm going to ask you the same five questions and I'll give you an extra 5 seconds on the clock too. Now, if you give the same answer as Tracy, you will hear this sound and I'll ask you to try again, OK?
Yes.
And if you say pass, we'll come back if there's time too. Can we remind everybody of Tracy's answers? And 25 seconds on the clock too, please. The time starts from the end of the first question. Good luck, Aaron. If you're bored, name something you might like to look at.
Magazine.
Tell me a breakfast food people might also eat for dinner.
Weet-Bix.
Try again.
Toast.
Name something women worry about.
Their looks.
Name something you do while you're listening to music.
Bop your head
Name a kind of clock.
Grandfather.
Great job.
Can I turn around?
Is that it, Grant? Is that it? Am I done? It felt good, felt good. Let's find out. Ready, big fella?
Yes.
Do it. If you're bored, name something you might like to look at, you said. Magazines. The survey says... five. Now, the top answer was TV. Tracy had that. Tell me a breakfast food that people might also eat for dinner. You're both trying to say Weet-Bix. You said... toast. Survey says... 16. Eggs was the top answer.
Oh, yeah, of course.
You guys eat a lot of Weet-Bix in the house?
Well, our boy does, but we both eat eggs for dinner, so we should have got that.
Yeah?
One of us should anyway.
But you didn't.
No. You need one. Half of it. Yeah, we have eggs on toast. Yeah.
You need 116 for $10,000. Name something women worry about. You said... their looks. The survey says... 19. Weight was the top answer. Okay. Name something you do while you're listening to music. You said... yep. I bopped my head, Grant. I bopped my head.
Do you? You a head bopper?
Yeah.
We saw you in there, actually. It wasn't much other arm action. It was just all head, wasn't it?
Head bopping.
Just a bit of that.
Glad to do it.
Just bopping me head. Survey says...
no good.
Sing was the top answer. Ouch. Now, we need 97 now for $10,000. Remain positive. Name a kind of clock. You said... grandfather. The good news is that this is the top answer.
Oh, come on.
But is it enough for $10,000? No! No! Great try though, Aaron. A lot of fun. Did you enjoy it?
I did.
He enjoyed it. He didn't quite get there, but they do get $10 for every fast money point, and they'll be back again tomorrow night for another shot at $10,000. Thanks for watching, everybody. Join us again tomorrow night, and we all play Family Feud, and stay tuned right now for the project. News for all the families. I'm Grant Denyer. Good night, Australia.